I'm from Finland. It's a Finland national custom, right? 欢迎啦。How's everybody? Good. Yeah, perfecto. Wonderful. Me too. Yeah. Originally, we wanted to move out today, but you're lucky. You can stay here now. Yeah, thanks to the management of the hotel. Yeah. Especially the director. Yeah.And his immediate staff, yeah, they're very kind to us. They are very, very kind. I really mean it, yeah? When we first arrived, we were very, you know, excited. Everybody was so excited, huh? Everything's very chaotic, but we're okay now, huh? We better, huh? More discipline, right? You want to ask anything? Yes, go ahead, go ahead.
I want to ask you about two countries.
Two countries?
I'm from Russia.
Russia,
Moscow.
Yes.
I want to ask you about people of my country, Russia, and people of country, Belarus.
Belarus and Russia, yeah.
Russia is so big country, but only 15 of us here.
Yes.
Maybe 40 of us.
Yes.
And why?
Only 15 people
there
here?
There are so...kind and good people in our country. Very, very many people in our country. And why they practice?
Why only 15?
We are only 50.
Well, better than nothing.
Yes. I want to know about future of my country and Belarus.
Belarus and Russia?
Russia.
Uh-huh.Well, I don't know. I have to go there. You like Belarus people?
Yes, they are very kind and
yes.
Tolerant. So good.
Yes, I know.
So hard.
I know, of course, of course. Most human beings are very kind. It's just now and again we have some, you know, a little bit unkind people.And that's how things happen.
What about Russia?
Russian, also very kind. I told you already, I was there. And I really like your people. The future of Belarus, the future of Russia, all hang together with the future of humankind at the whole. You understand? So, more or less, you know, some country are more, some country are less developed spiritually.But if humankind as a whole develop together spiritually, then the future of Belarus, the future of Russian is the same. Almost the same like everywhere else, yeah? And if only 15 Russian people come here, I don't care. I don't care if only five, I don't care if only one. You represent your country. And that's enough. We don't really think of numbers, you know what I mean? Yes.Besides, it is said, you know, the old wisdom, it is said that any country who can produce 10 great beings, great men, you know, great human, that country will not know destruction. You understand? So 15 is 50% more than God expected already. You understand? Yes.Any country who has 10 person like you, good practitioner like you, never be destroyed. You see that? And you're 15. Congratulations. Yes. Any country who can produce 10 person who is virtuous,who is spiritually developed, fit in the eyes of God, will never know destruction. So this is very good for Russian already. Yeah? Okay, huh? So if you think you have too much, you can lend 5 extra to Belarus. And, and they can produce 5 more and then they'll be okay. All right? Yeah. But I'm sure we have some already in Belarus. Yes. We have more than 15. You just came only 15, but we have more than that. Okay? Don't worry. Some people don't go to center, but they meditate at home. Yeah. Some people, because of their name and their position, they don't want to disclose their identity as a spiritual practitioners, because in the society, sometimes people do not understand what is it, the spiritual practitioner. So they want to keep it quiet. And this is rightly so. It's okay. Yeah? All right. All right. Next question? Yeah.
Hello, Master.
Hello there. Are you still dreaming of the guy?
Yes.
Yeah, what happened?
I'm from Greece, and we love you very much. And we are three of us, three initiates. Initially, there were more than 100.
Yeah, I know. Don't worry about that. So what happened now?
We really have some hope there?
A hope?
Hope.
What?
If people come contact with the truth and they abandon it.
You don't know if they abandon or not, okay?
Yes.
Some people like to practice alone. Yeah?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Or they live too far, they don't want to come to the center, or they are in a different time, you know, like they work Sunday, they work Saturday and Sunday, instead of Monday to Friday like everybody else. Or maybe their family is a little difficult. Don't let them go to group meditation. Yeah, everything happens. It's the heart is important, yeah? If they meditate at home, it's fine. Yeah, okay? Yeah, all right.
Thank you so much.
Even today, I have one driver, you know, who drives me around. He said his wife also gave him problem because he goes to group meditation. Well, we just have to accept whatever situation in this world. We do our best, but we cannot always alter the situation. No. Okay. Any more? Don't worry about the number. You know, maybe different timing, things will come different, okay? Yes. And besides, not everyone can keep the discipline. Yeah? Or the vegetarian diet, you know. To us, it's normal, simple, and it's a the only way of life, you know, and the very logical way of life, but to some people, it's an ordeal, you know? It's like a drama for them. I don't understand it, but it's like that. The karma, you know, pulling them too strongly, and they probably are not strong enough to go against it, and that's the problem. Yeah? Yeah, just pray for them if you want. Yeah. Number three is a good number, you know? Like the Father and Son, the Holy Ghost. Huh? And in Buddhism, you know, the Buddha,
yes,
the Sangha, and the Dharma. See that? Yeah, lucky number. Don't worry. You know, I'm telling you the truth. I'd rather have only one or two, but very intelligent, very deeply, spiritually ingrained, than a lot of people and just come just for the sake of being crowded and, you know, I don't understand nothing. Yeah, these people, they really bug me sometimes. Do you understand? Yeah. And the number is nothing. Number is not everything. No. Hmm? Jesus is the only one, but he's influenced many generations. See? Buddha, only one. And look how many people influenced, yeah? And like even Muhammad, only one. Krishna, only one. For example, huh? See that? Okay. Pythagoras, yes. Socrates, yes. I know many Greeks people are very enlightened. You came from very, very deep spiritual culture. Okay. Ah, voila, next one. Ça va? Okay.
Yes, Master. In one of your books you wrote about it takes more lives to become a woman body.
Yep.
I've been thinking very much about it, like...
You want one?
Yeah, no, that I'm sitting here is thanks to my wife, and but I was wondering how many lives?
How many more lives do you become a woman? You don't want to be a woman anymore, you want to go up. No more life. That's the best. I'm just talking about general, okay? General of the human evolution. You understand? Or the spiritual evolution is different, huh? Once you are initiated, you don't think of woman, man anymore. You finish, you have no sex. Sexless. I mean it. Next one, guys. No more? Ah, that's cool. Yeah, one by one. Okay? Yes. Wait, chocolate. Yeah, come on.
Yeah, hello, Master.
Hello.
I'm just initiated 2 months ago, so maybe my question is for the other one, not so interested.
You never know.
So the first question is, how important is our physical body in our spiritual way, to be aware of it?
Okay. The physical body is to enable you to do your spiritual practice. So the longer you stay in it, the better for you, since you are here. Yeah? The longer time you have, you can practice more and your level will be higher. And that's the physical body, the help of the physical body. Okay?
Yeah, what I mean is mostly if we are sitting in meditation, all is fun, all is well, we are in peace. But if we come out in life, we so easily get reactions. We have something, we react on the past, or we follow our needs, or we follow the thoughts, or the physical things.
Yeah,
and that's why my question is, must we not be aware more of this, what has happened inside our body, of the emotions and of the thoughts, to come over this habit?
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay.
And is it enough only to meditate and it will be happen to Kuan Yin, that we don't get reactions anymore, because mostly the reactions are related to our past?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and the karma you have with other people, yeah. But that also, in time, will become less and less. With the meditation that I have taught you, yes. Of course, it takes time, no? 2 months is nothing in the infinity. Some people, 2 years, 20 years, they still haven't got nowhere. It depends on how concentrated we are during the time of meditation. Depends on how big our fixed karma for this lifetime. Yes, many factor. But if you react to something in a usual way, then do not be alarmed. You know, you have not become Buddha in one day. Even Shakyamuni didn't. Jesus also takes some time. All right?
Okay.
Yeah, don't worry.
Thank you.
Yes. The reaction, don't mind. If you can, for example, if you're often angry before, yeah? And now after 2 months of meditation, you thought you become less angry, but you are not. It doesn't matter, you know. Just let it be. If you can avoid it or you can minimize your anger, then it's fine. If not, it's okay. Try next time. Yeah? Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you try your best and I'm proud of you already. The second question you forget.
No, it was the second question. They were related to
right.
each other.
Oh, okay, cool.
I have a question about the planets and the moon and stuff. I've been thinking for a long time about them and what type of being manifests as a planet and, you know, how great they are, what their level is.
It depends on their level of practice also, yeah? For example, the sun is fourth level, for example, yeah? The whole being of the sun, yes? And the people who live there, some are four, some are third level, yeah? And the people who live in the moon, similar. Okay? Yes. You can go on forever, you know. Each being has different spiritual attainment, yeah? And they manifest themselves in some different form to help others and to develop themselves. Because the more they help others, the more they develop spiritually.
Yeah.
Just like us, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
And how many people live there? Is that what you mean? No, I cannot count.
No.
Okay, don't worry about that. They're not overpopulated like us.
But are those planets parents to the beings living on them?
No, not necessarily.
No?
Not necessarily. Just like we live on the Earth planet, but it's not necessarily that the Earth is our parents, okay? We sometimes say Mother Earth, yeah, but it's just a way of speaking.
Right.
All right?
Because they take care of us?
Yeah, because the Earth is so kind, you know. The Earth nourishes all beings and indiscriminately, so we call the Earth Mother Earth, and it's rightly so, it's fine, yeah? All right. Okay, but all beings came from God. Next.
Well, first, I want to say thank you, Master, for helping me be here tonight. It's been a long process for me to get up to where I am, but I am very happy, and I thank you. But I also want to thank your staff and thank the guards and thank the cooks, because I found myself the other night getting a little frustrated, you know, with like the rooms and being so crowded. But then when I look how hard the cooks were working and the guards and how dedicated the Chinese were and sleeping outside and nowhere to go, it really made me open up, you know, and have more compassion to see. It doesn't matter whether there's 15 or 20 people in my room, you know, look at these people. They're doing so much for us, and I'm just so grateful and thankful for the things they did. So I would like to thank you and your staff.
That's right. That's right. I also want to thank them. Yes. I'm always grateful. Whenever I see them working or standing there, I'm always grateful in my heart. And if I have time, most of the time, I treat them specially. Yeah, like I invite them to my room and we eat together, you know, whoever can. Eh? Not always all the staff can come, yeah? Not always all the worker can come, but if I have a chance, I always try to find a way to thank them in different way, yeah? Say it with food, say it with chocolate, oh, just to say thank you, yeah. I will thank them for you when I have a chance. Yeah? Okay? Very good that you see this. Very good. Very good observation. Wonderful. You're getting better. Huh? Your eyes more open. See? Telling you, practicing does help. This is the right attitude. Yes. I'm very frustrated sometimes to see people just complaining, and see the negative side of life, but don't see anything better than that. You know, she's right. The room is very crowded. I'm very aware of that, and I don't feel very good about it. But this is the biggest hotel maybe in the world. And this is all they can produce, and they put up with all kind of, you know, our, you know, sometimes very strange behaviors, you know, like they don't understand why when you see a woman, all of you, you just gone berserk. You know, especially you haven't seen this woman before in your whole lifetime, yeah? And you cry and you yell, you know, all kind of thing, and you push each other to come to that woman, and they feel, my God, what kind of people are these, you know? So the hotel staff also feel very, you know, strange like you do. And be happy that you are in a hotel room. I was going to take you into the campsite to sleep with the mosquitoes, yeah. Luckily, the management have arranged something, so we have more room now, and we could stay here, yeah? We really overwhelm them with our population, yeah. It's more than we expected. And even some more people wanted to come, and we have to refuse them. We don't even have room here for ourselves. No room to sit. While you are sitting here, there are thousands of others have to sit somewhere else. You know that, right? I mean, our own people have to sit some different room because we don't have even... This is the biggest conference room in Bangkok. I mean, in Thailand. And we don't have enough room to house everybody. Yeah? And even then, if this hotel management are not kind, we would have to go somewhere else, in a campsite or something, yeah? And we were not prepared because we thought we were going to live in a hotel. So nobody brought any, tent with us. So you might have slept outside, you know, under a small canvas and be friends with the mosquitoes. Be happy that you are here, yeah? be happy that you squeeze in one room. Sometimes you don't have to sleep there. You're supposed to come and meditate. Huh? Why you complain about 15 people in the room? What are they doing, 15 people in the room? What are you doing in the room? Huh? You're supposed to go there just to change, just to freshen up. Yeah, go to bathroom and then come go meditate. You got it? All right, no complaining. Ah, I did not know you are in the room. Now you tell me. We're supposed to be like Hungary retreat, you know, just sit all day, all night. Never mind, you have a choice. Then you go and look for the other room, which is empty one. The one that who sit in this meditation hall, the room will be empty. And you go and sneak in there. Then it doesn't have to be 15. Okay? Right. Next one.
Hello. Sorry.
Yeah?
How are you, Master? Okay, I'm so happy to be here too. I have no complaints.
Good.
Really, really. I'm lucky enough, I'm happy enough because I'm in the room, but I can see so many people are sleeping outside on the road, so I'm so sorry for them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so my question is about my feeling, emotion. Emotion, if I'm too emotional,
yeah.
My emotion can hinder my spiritual growth, development.
Yeah.
How can I manage and control my, especially negative emotions?
Okay, it's like this. Emotion doesn't really hinder your spiritual practice. It just means that if you have too much emotion, that means you're still too near to the astral plane. That's all, okay? I mean, your spiritual development isn't that great yet. That's all, okay? So once you get more over it, then you go higher, yeah. But it's not like you don't have emotion at all after a while, you know, like if you practice long and then you become like a stone or something. No, it just, what I mean is, if you it's, it has to be appropriate, you know? Like for example, you practice spiritual, yeah? But then your husband left you and you love that man dearly, of course you cry. It would be weird if you don't cry. You understand? Yeah. It would be weird if you laugh, yeah? Unless you wanted to get rid of him. Yes. there was a joke about, there was a guy, you know, who speed very fast on the highway, and the police run after him. After a while, he stopped. And the police asked him, why did you run so fast? I mean, okay, this is weekend, and it's my last hour, so if you have a very good excuse, I will not give you a ticket and let you go. So the guy scratched his head and said, you know, you look like the guy, you know. And the police say, what guy? He say, my wife ran away with a policeman last week. And he looks like you. Mm. So when you are chasing after me, I was thinking maybe that man wants to return my wife. I run away. Understand, yeah? Okay. And there was also a girl, you know, girl left her husband. Came home and was crying with her mother. And then after a while, she said, mother, but I'm so worried about John, because when I left him, I heard some banging noise inside my house. You think he's going to be okay, mom? Mother said, oh, don't worry. It was just champagne. He opened the champagne. Celebrate. Okay, let's get serious again. Next one. I don't know why they talk bad about us women all the time. Yeah.
yeah, I'm working as a massage therapist, and I have a question. I wonder if is this really damaging my practice, is 2.5 or 3 hours enough every day to cover this? Me being in contact with people, you know.
Okay, you must
Should I quit?
Just physically, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't matter. It's all right. You
it's
have to
right.
do your job.
Great.
And recite the name, the holy name.
Yeah.
Okay?
During the time, during...
During, after, before, any time.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We cannot help to get contact with people all the time, either massage or anything else, yeah. Okay.
Hello, Master.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
And by the way, thanks for Malaga. It changed my life totally.
It did? It didn't change your neck, though. What happened? You attacked to it. Okay. What now?
Yeah, I'm a bit confused about what you said about emotions.
Yes.
Because I've got very strong emotions with animals.
Uh-huh.
With the pain they have to feel because of our humans.
Yes.
And it's always, when I see, for example, an animal driven dead by the car on street, I have to cry,
know.
You know? And I can't, it's really hard to stand for me what happens to the animals in this world.
I understand.
And I always thought, okay, maybe this shows that I'm a very good soul, that I feel for the animals, for these poor beings. But now, after you said it's not so spiritual good to have so much emotions, I don't know, maybe if I'm wrong, that I feel so much for the animals.
No, I didn't say that.
So I understand wrong?
No. I mean, if it's appropriate, you understand me? I just say now, if her husband left her, she would cry. And that's normal, okay? You don't become a stone after being a spiritual practitioner. But some people, they just cry for anything. Do you understand me? Always complaining and crying and self-pity. That's a different thing, yeah? But if you have... that's not emotion, that's compassion.
Okay.
Okay, that's number one. I, even myself, sometimes I have to block my mind of remembering what the human is doing to animals in the laboratory or in the slaughterhouse. Otherwise, I cannot even wink, I cannot even sleep. I cannot even do anything else. I just want to go out and screaming. I just run around the world and scream at everybody and tell them to stop it right now. I cannot bear it. That's why we do all this thing for animals, you know, the alternative living, and we air in a great hero, and we are promoting all this. Do you understand? That's the least that we can do. Yeah? If I don't have those emotions, I wouldn't have done all this. You know? This is different.
Okay.
All right?
Oh, thank you.
Because we have very poor language, so everything we say emotion, it's not like that. It's not like that. Some people just complaining all the time and always think of the negative things, no matter how good things are. You understand me?
Yeah.
That's a different, okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. It's difficult to express. This is not emotion. Emotion has many ways, yeah? Okay? All right. Next one? Yeah.
Okay. Hi, Master.
Hi.
Thank you for this blessing to be able to see you after such a long time. I'm very grateful. My question is about the fifth level.
The fifth?
Yes. When we reach the fifth level and we feel oneness, will we also feel one with you, that we are you and you are us? And will we feel that actually we exist on all levels? On all of the different levels at once, because God is everything.
Yeah.
And is it true that actually in heaven there is no hierarchy? It doesn't matter. The level doesn't matter because everything from God is perfect, even the lowest level and the highest level.
It's not true like that. But if you don't know anything, for example, other beings, yeah? They don't know anything about the fifth level. Nobody have ever told them about the fifth level. And by some chance, they are able to go to, just say, even second level, yeah? And they will feel that the Lord of the second level is God Almighty. And they will also feel one with that God. Or the third level, yeah, even astral level, okay?
I was wondering about religion. I understand that all religion is beautiful. I study many different spiritual paths for religion. But I understand that the sound and the light was originally a part of all religion. And if religion was like a human body, and some parts of our body we don't use anymore, maybe like people get their appendix removed or whatever, but the heart and the mind we still have use for. Now, the sound and the light are like the same for religion. They are the cornerstone, they are the backbone. How is it that something so crucial to spirituality got removed from religion altogether, and now that we have only, I mean, without you, Master, I don't know.
As human brain, human mind interfere with everything. You can find a remnant of the indication of it in every scripture. But one blind lead the other blind, and we're going nowhere. You see what I mean?
Yes.
That's why they crucified Jesus. That's why they wanted to assassinate Buddha. That's why they're harassing the Muslim when Muhammad was still alive. Do you understand me? What can we do? That's why Master have to keep coming again and again, one after another. Because if the human, even when the Master is alive, they don't even know about it. They don't understand what the Master is talking about. So afterward, they just a doctrine left over, you know? Just like, okay, now when I'm alive, I give you initiation. And then you can see the light, you can hear the sound to some extent, and then develop yourself. But once I'm dead, all this talk won't help anybody. Yeah? Will not help anybody to hear the light, to hear the sound. They just read about it. Oh, the light, the sound, the light, the sound. What is the light and what is the sound? And then because they don't understand, they see, oh, how good we are, you know, maybe some outsider even, yeah? And we see how good we are together, and they think, oh, there's something good about it. But they don't understand, and they don't want to enter our circle of, you know, practitioner. And they just look outside, and then they want to do the same stuff, yeah? That's one thing. And then they continue that way. Whether I'm alive or dead is a different, for them it's different, yeah? And after I die, they just keep all this doctrine and become like Qinghaiism, who knows? Yeah, Buddhism, Christian, after Christ is Christian, after Buddha is Buddhism, after Mohammed is Mohammedan, blah, blah. You see what I mean?
Yes. The reason I was asking, because I teach a youth group at a Christian church, a Sunday school, and sometimes I get so frustrated, the material they give me is just useless. The kids are starving spiritually. I ask them, do you know God? Do you feel inside? And they say no, you know, and they, because the information is just pointless. I mean, so many times I pray to you and I just take what they give me and I try and sneak some master in there because they need it so badly. And yeah. I'm worried about for the generation, you know, we have, they go to church and then they go do potlucks and the meat everywhere. And I think, how is this ever going to help them to progress at all? It's, this church is sick. It needs wellness from you, Master. So we're just grateful to be a part of this.
C'est comme ça, la vie.
Yeah.
I'm working very hard, but I'm not that successful.
Yeah.
Your master is a loser.
Mm? No, Master, you are so wonderful.
Yeah.
We love you so much.
Look at how many people follow my teaching. Huh? And look at how many people follow whatever out there. Then, you know, huh? I don't consider myself a very successful master, but I do what I can, and we do what we can, huh? And that's fine, yeah. What to do, huh? Yeah, well, I could do more, but I don't know how. Sometimes I feel powerless also. In this world, I'm powerless.
Thank you so much.
Recently, I went to a conference hall in Greece, and previously it was a slaughterhouse.
Ah,
and
yes.
I started feeling uncomfortable and had pictures of panic and fright, and I didn't know why. So after a while, I inquired about the history of the place. They told me that it was a slaughterhouse. And then I realized why I had these pictures
yes.
and these emotions.
Yeah, so, your vision. The vision.
Yes,
yeah.
yes, and pain.
Yeah.
I felt the pain and the panic.
Yes.
So I started reciting the names and really cried for them. And I saw your presence there. And their souls, I felt that their souls were liberated.
Mm-hmm.
They were previously entrapped in pain,
yes.
in a level of pain.
Yes.
And through the reciting of names
yeah.
and the prayer, they were liberated.
Yeah, wonderful.
And I was grateful. Oh. And they were grateful immediately.
I'm grateful to you. Oh. That you were there.
Thank you. They were liberated.
You bring love and blessing to them.
Yes, thanks to you. Thanks to you. I brought you there. And it was such peace all over the place. And
that
I immediately
life.
Felt better. So I knew. And Master, another thing. You gave a recipe for wine. And I think that if we could produce a wine, an alcohol, without alcohol, then it would help people a lot. Because wine goes along with meat eating. And I think we would help people a lot.
They have a lot of non-alcoholic wine out there already.
We don't know that in Greece. And in London, I think you gave a recipe, so, but without giving the specifics. So
okay, well, you have a recipe somewhere, no? Before, you know? I don't remember. When I do something, I just do it spontaneously. But they have a recipe somewhere from Melly.
I'll inquire.
Okay?
I'll inquire about this. Thank
yeah,
you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, I have told you guys that if you practice this Kuan Yin method, diligently and sincerely, your presence will bring untold blessing to wherever you go. And all beings will be grateful to you, not just five generations. You are the living God, the walking blessing. You are the walking, the living, the breathing blessing of God, the representative of heaven wherever you go. Yes? Now you can see it yourself. Because you can see the vision and you know it. Some people don't know it. Whether you know it or not, you are the representative of this great blessing power after initiation. Wherever you go, people, beings, will feel the blessing from you, will feel the love through you, and will be liberated by your sincere practice. By being a good tool, yes, you will liberate countless beings without you even knowing, or with you knowing. It depends on how, you know, clear you are with your spiritual knowledge, okay? You know it or not know it, you still do blessing, yeah? So this sister, she know and she see it. But some of you don't. You just do it automatically. Even you don't know, you still bless people or any being, wherever you go, okay? So feel honor. All right? You are really great. You should feel proud. Not arrogant, but proud. That you bring blessing, peace, and love wherever you walk. You are really that great. I told you, I teach you to find your great self. Maybe you don't know it, or maybe you know it. But you still are. Okay? Wonderful, wonderful. I like this kind of story. Yes. Right, you're welcome.
Hello, Master. Can you hear me?
Sure can.
I have an initiate who was initiated 2 days ago. He has a question. He's going to say it in Persian, and I'll translate it for you.
Okay.
Is that okay?
بعد از عرض سلام علیکم. من این پرشیم. بعد از عرض سلام میخواستم ببینم من 2 سال کانوینینت کار کردم و موقع میتیشن بدنم شروع کرد به حرکت به من گفتن که این حرکت به خاطر تداخل انرژی با انرژی شماست همخونی نداره انرژی ما میخواستم ببینم که واقعا همینجوره
The question is, before he got initiated, he was doing the convenient method for 2 years. But during his meditation, Without his control, he was actually twirling like the whirling dervishes of Sufism. The question is, he's heard that the reason for this could have been the big difference between his vibration and your vibration, which was actually creating this. Is that true?
It's not always true. It's not always true.
میخواستم بدونم که انرژی که روح از روی روح اثر میذاره چرا روی جسم من داره اثر دورانی ایجاد میکنه.
The follow-up question is the energy which should be affecting his soul, why is it so much affecting his body, his physical being?
Okay. Sometimes the physical being has not been purified long enough because we are so used to it, influence of the world. Yes, it's not only him, it's the place where he lived, the spiritual background, the belief that he had before he came, and maybe the food that he has been consuming. It's not that he wanted it, but he did not know, you see? So even though with the vegetarian for a long time, 3 months, 2 months, it has not completely purify the spiritual body of the body. Yeah. Therefore, when the stronger energy coming into contact with our usual energy, it create a little bit of the the movement. But nothing to worry about. You just concentrate here and let the body do its one. Do not pay attention. Yes, or maybe he was a dervish in the last life, and now he still gets used to it. Okay, have fun, exercise. The body exercise, well, your soul is, enjoying. It doesn't matter. Don't pay attention to anything of the body. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
میخواستم ازتون تشکر کنم. من 3 روزه که تشرف گرفتم و این لطف که شما در حق من کردید.
He wants to thank you for your grace that the past 3 days it's been initiated now, and he's very grateful.
Oh, you are very welcome. Thank God. Yeah, thanks heaven. Thank your good karma. Yeah. Explain to him.
Okay.
I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to him.
He's got translation.
He got translation. Yes. What language are you speaking?
Persian.
Ah, very nice language. Yeah, very nice language.
Thank you.
Yeah, I wanted you to translate because it's very nice language. So we have it on tape later.
Okay, okay.
Translate the whole thing.
The whole thing,
yep.
From the beginning.
Yep.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. استاد فرمودن دلیل این که این حرکت چرخش و دورانی رو مثل دراویش داشتی به خاطر این بودش که بدن امکان داشته که به اندازه کافی پاکیزه و منزه نبوده، اونم نه به خاطر اینکه خودت این عمدن این کار کردی، به خاطر غذایی که خوردی، به خاطر محیطی که زندگی کردی، به خاطر تأثیر آدم‌های دور و برت. ولی اتفاقی که افتاد وقتی که مراقبه می‌کردی، این انرژی خیلی قوی به سراغت اومد و این باعث شد که یک چرخشی درت به وجود بیاد. شاید در زندگی قبلت یک درویش بودی.
Beautiful language. Very nice.
Thank you.
Very nice. Thank you. How you say thank you in Persian?
Mainly two words. One is the French one, which is like merci. So it's the merci in French.
Well, that I can say it.
Yes.
Merci.
And the second one is mutshakkiram.
Mutshakkiram?
That's it.
That sounds nicer.
Lovely.
Mutshakkiram. I'm very glad you came.
Thank you, Master.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank God you can come. Thanks Allah that you can come.
Allah thank you.
Blessed be Allah that He helped you so much, He loved you so much, that you can come here to be our brothers and sisters. Please thank Allah, everybody.
Thank you, Allah.
Allah is great. Say that. Allah is great.
Allah is great.
Yeah, in Persian language. which say Allah is great, God is great. Yeah? Kuda Bozok asked. I cannot say it. Can you say it? Koda Bozok asked. Allah is great. Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Without God, without Allah. Allah means God in Persian language, yeah? It's not a strange God, just a name in Persian. Yeah, in English it's God, in Persian is Allah, yeah? So you can say Allah is great or God is great. Without Allah, nothing happened, yeah? Without Allah's blessing, we cannot do nothing, yeah? So we always have to thank God, thank Allah. That's correct, okay? Don't forget ever to always thank God. So, my God, I'm so happy you came. Allah must love you very much. Good for your country. Good for your country. Yes. Oh, my God. You must be very sincere. When you are sincere and want something, Allah will help. Always. No problem. Never forget God. Question? Yes. Yes, yes. You can speak in Persian and she translate.
با تشکر از استاد عزیزم یه سوالی داشتم در رابطه با طبقات هستی. طبق صحبت هایی که شما قبلا کردین طبقه فیزیکی ما پایین ترین طبقه است. بعد من میخواستم ببینم آیا منظور از طبقات فیزیکی فقط کل کره زمین یا کرات دیگر هم شامل میشه؟
The question is about the different levels of consciousness. Is the planet Earth the only physical planet? If not, are the other ones in the solar system?
Yes, many more.
میگن yes. بله چند خیلی هستن که توی
many more physical planets.
پس باید دوم سوال تو بکن.
We have no, people like us. How similar?
Okay. And then he's got a follow-up.
Yes.
طبق صحبت شما طبقه فیزیکی چون پایین ترین طبقه است خواستم ببینم انظر سطح هوشیاری طبقه زمین کره زمین پایینه بعد کرات دیگه هم چون فیزیکی هستن پس باید انظر هوشیاری پایین باشن پس چرا ما میتونیم بگیم که طبق صحبت های شما البته کرات دیگه انظر هوشیاری اعلام کردیم که بالا هستن چرا زمین ها پس ما طبق اونها حساب نمی کنیم مثلا ماه و زهره رو شنیدم که انظر سطح و لول بالا هستن در صورتی که فیزیکی هستن
I don't understand, but I feel very intelligent question.
Well, I hope it is, so you'll hear it. The follow-up question to that physical level thing is, I've heard from your speeches before that there are beings in other planets in the solar system, like planets like even the moon or the Venus, and their consciousness is more than the human beings.
No, not necessary.
She wants to get some clarification.
Not necessary. As I said before, like some. The being in the moon, they are either third level or fourth level. The being is in the sun, similar. Yes.
موجودات مال ستاره، مال ماه و خورشید امکان داره موجودات طبقه سوم یا چهارم هوشیاری باشن.
But you see, they are not like developing like us. You see, we are some of us don't have as a big. High level as them, but we are catching up with them now. And some of us are higher level than some than a being in the moon or in the sun, for example.
استاد میگن ولی اونا به سریعی ما نمیتونن که تو کره زمین هستیم به اصطلاح تکامل پیدا بکنن. ما بعضیامون تو کره زمین امکان داره طبقه سوم و طبقات بالاتر هم هستیم ولی اونجا نه دیگه بیشتر نیستن.
Because they are invisible. Being.
و اونها نامرئی ان.
Yes. Any invisible being or any physical being, sometimes either they're born lower level or they're born higher level. If they don't have a spiritual teacher to teach them, they stay like that.
چه کسانی که نامر یعنی موجوداتی که نامری هستن یا معمولی هستن اگر استاد نداشته باشن تو همون حدی که هستن میمونن حالا میخواد طبقه سوم باشه یا چهارم باشه
yes. They have no problem at all but they just don't change
مشکلی ندارن ولی خب تکامل هم پیدا نمیکنن yeah. تغییر نمیکنن ولی yes. ما انسان ها
in this spiritual in this physical level we have advantage that in the human body is quicker to progress in spiritual practice if you have a spiritual master to guide you
ما یه مزیتی که داریم روی کره زمین تو این دنیای فیزیکی کره زمین اینه که اگر یک استاد زنده داشته باشیم میتونیم سریع پیشرفت بکنیم و ما تغییرات رو میتونیم ببینیم
yes but in this physical planet is a lot of suffering
اما توی این کره زمین خیلی رنج و عذاب وجود داره
in the moon in the sun or other planet some other planet no
در ماه یا خورشید یا سیارات دیگه ستاره دیگه این عذاب وجود نداره
they don't know what suffering is
نمیدونن اصلا عذاب و رنج یعنی چی
that word in their dictionary
حتی توی دیکشنریشون این لغت رو ندارن
they don't even have a dictionary
حتی دیکشنری هم ندارن
they don't need verbal language
احتیاج به زبان محاوره ای ندارن
They enjoy peace, happiness, stability, and spiritual bliss, and they enjoy telepathy.
از صلح و شادمانی و پیشرفت معنوی خودشون لذت میبرن و از تلپاتی استفاده میکنن.
In a way, they are highly developed. You see, but we have the advantage of having the body and having this suffering to motivate us. To practice quicker.
ما به خاطر این بدنی که داریم یه انگیزه برای ما که به خاطر درد و رنجی که میکشیم سریعتر بریم جلو.
In the moon and the sun, for example, huh? They don't have any problem.
برای مثال توی ماه و خورشید موجودات هیچ مشکلی ندارن.
They enjoy blissful all the time.
فقط احساس خیلی شادمانی و خوبی و به اصطلاح صورت yeah. صفا می کنند
They don't feel the need to practice anymore yes.
احتیاجی نمی بینن که هیچ ممارست و تمرینی بکنن برای پیشرفتشون
So it's very seldom that they can jump to the fifth level like a human being here we can jump to the fifth level
خیلی به ندرته که بتونن برسن به درجه پنجم مثل ما انسان ها که بتونیم بریم به درجه
yeah,
پنجم
but what a price we have to pay here
اما با چه قیمتی باید ما این کارو بکنیم اینجا
yeah even being a master what a price any master has to pay look at Jesus look at Muhammad look at the Buddha etc many other look at some of the Sikh masters for example they've been persecuted they've been harassed Oh, they've been even fly alive, they've been all kind of, they've been treated so cruelly for being a master on this physical planet. If they are a master on even an astral planet, they don't ever have such thing. Even just an astral planet, nobody persecute them there. And being here, over there, even astral planet beings, they are more, how do you say, sensitive to the teaching. They're more perceptive to the teaching?
To the teaching.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yeah,
that's it.
Yeah.
See? Anything on this physical planet is hell. It's difficult. Because we have this body. The body is a beautiful vehicle, but it's also a great hindrance. Yeah. It makes all kind of trouble. It makes war within nations. It makes war within religions. It makes war between religions. It make war with between nations. It make war between each other, between family members, between husband and wife. Just because of this physical body, it has a mind, a brain in it. And it's been programmed so in many different ways that the two programs are never alike. And so we clash with each other most of the time. And that's how we have problem on this planet, you see? But this is very good instrument also. It's like a knife with two ends, you know? Yeah, difficult to maneuver. Hey, capisce? Understand?
Can ایشون فرمودن که همه اساتیدی که روی کره زمین اومدن یک جوری باید یک قیمتی رو پرداخت میکردن، از حضرت محمد گرفته تا بودا تا تمام اساتید سیک و ادیان دیگه، یا میکشتنشون یا براشون جنگ درست میکردن یا دنبالشون میکردن و زندگی اصلا راحتی نداشتن. و بعد میرسه به اینکه ولی ما با اینکه رنج و درد میبینیم تو این دنیا و بدنمونو خداوند بهمون داده و هیچ دو انسانی رو یک برنامه یگانه نداده، همین باعث میشه که بین ما جنگ باشه، بین دو نفر، بین زن و شوهر دعوا باشه، بین کشورها دعوا باشه، سر مذاهب دعوا باشه. و این هم فقط به خاطر اینه که ما این بدن رو گرفتیم و برای رشدمون میخواییم بریم. این اون چکیده‌ای بود که من فهمیدم، اگه کم اومد میبخشید. I just said, excuse me if I didn't catch all of it. I did my best try to catch all of it.
Oh, good, good. You've done your best. It's wonderful. Any more questions? You're welcome. Yes, over there, please.
گفته بودم چو بیایی غم دل با تو بگویم. چه بگویم که غم از دل برود چون تو بیایی.
I feel so beautiful. I don't know what it is.
That is a piece of poetry.
Oh, no wonder. I wanted to cry when I hear she speaks and I don't understand the language.
Well, I mean, the meaning of it is I was full of sadness, not knowing that you were coming. When you came, all my sadness went. So it's something like that.
Wonderful. It's very wonderful.
که شوهرم و دخترام خیلی با من همکاری کردن که من بیام اینجا. شوهرم خواست که به استاد سلام برسونم و بگم که انشالله یه روزی هم خانواده های گیاهخوارا رو دعوت کنن. و اینکه دخترم خواست، استاد رو نقاشی کرده بود، صورت استاد به شکل نور بود، استاد در حالت مدیتیشن، و خواسته بود که به استاد بگم وقتی که استاد مدیتیشن میکنه تمام فرشته های آسمون به حال ایشون قبطه میخورن.
Okay, you cannot translate. It is too beautiful.
Yes, I can. Yes, it is. I'm so touched.
Okay.
The husband, her husband, and her eldest daughter say their love to you, Master, and they have been so cooperative, and they have been doing their best to make sure that everything in place, so these guys
they can go,
can come over here, and
send my love to him. My thank you.
And also her daughter has done some painting. She's seen you, she's done some painting of you meditating and full of light.
Oh, wow. From a vision?
And then the husband said that he hopes that we will have families of vegetarians.
Yes.
More families of vegetarians coming.
I will be coming. We'll be coming. Just you keep your meditation strong and pray to Allah every day. It will come.
استاد فرمودن مراقبتون رو بکنین و از خداوند بخواین، دعا بکنین به درگاهش که این اتفاق بیفته انشاءالله. That means God willing.
Yes. One question. Do all the Persian girls look so beautiful like this? They do? Wow. What a race of people. What a race of beautiful people. I mean physically.
Okay. من میخواستم تشکر کنم خیلی خیلی زیاد، زندگی ما واقعا عوض کردی، ازت ممنونم. امروز هم فکر میکنم بهترین روز زندگی.
She's saying thank you so much for changing my life so greatly and today is the best day I've ever had in my life.
Welcome. Like your nail color. tell them, I also thank them.
منم از شما متشکرم.
All the families here.
همه شما، همه خانواده ازتون متشکرم.
It's them who changed their own life.
شما هستین که زندگی خودتون رو تغییر دادید.
I wasn't even ever in Persia yet. It's their high level of spiritual understanding that make them recognize you know, whatever they think is right. That means they have it within themselves.
میگن به خاطر عرفان والایی که شما دارید که میتونید به همچین حالتی باشید و خودتون خیلی چیزها رو درک بکنین به خاطر رشد معنویتونه.
They will bring a lot more blessing to their country.
خیلی رحم و شفقت و مهربانی و عظمت وارد کشورتون میکنید. شما این کارو خواهید
کرد. They will bring change, good change into their nation and their people. All of you.
همه شما.
Hero. Hero of Allah. Yeah. It's very difficult for them. They are very courageous, very brave. I know that.
استاد میفرمایند من میدونم که چقدر برای شما سخته ولی میدونم که خیلی شجاعید و خیلی هم براتون سخته این شجاعتتون رو من میدونم.
Yeah, especially because they are the pioneers. They are the first ones.
به خصوص که شما اولین ها هستید.
I thank them. I thank them for their nation.
تشکر میکنن از شما به خاطر ملیتتون.
For their bravery.
به خاطر شجاعتتون.
For their touching sincerity.
به خاطر خلوص نیتتون که آدمو تحت تاثیر قرار میده.
And welcome.
و خوش آمدید.
To family.
خوش آمدید به خانواده ما.
Yeah. Okay.
تشکر کنم و شکرگزاری کنم از حمایتی که شما طی بیماری طولانی مادرم داشتید حتی لحظه پرواز ایشون.
I like to thank you master for your protection when my mother with our mother passed away we could feel it.
Wonderful, wonderful.
من و بقیه اعضای خانواده
We are grateful. We felt your grace, all of us in the family, when it happened. All of us. Thank
Wonderful.
You.
Because they should feel happy. She go to a higher planet.
باید خوشحال باشین. ایشون رفته در درجات بالاتر.
با اطلاعاتی که ما از این متد به دست آوردیم، مفهوم دعا اونجوری که تو مذهب ما به ما یاد داده بودن تو ذهن ما تغییر کرده تو ذهن من بعد میخواستم بپرسم که با وجود اینکه خداوند از همه چی آگاهه و قادر به هر چیز و قانون کارمایی که قرار داده روی زمین دعا میتونه چه نقشی داشته باشه و چه کار انجام بده برای ما؟
Yes.
The question is, with this method of Kuan Yin,
yes.
There was a significant change in understanding what a prayer is.
What a
prayer is,
yes,
a prayer.
Yes, yes.
Because of the law of the karma on earth, how can we use prayer to help?
Others people?
Yeah.
Our meditation is the best prayers.
مراقبه‌ای که ما می‌کنیم بهترین دعاست. بهترین دعا و بهترین نماز.
It's a direct contact with the source of all blessing and all protection and all love.
به خاطر اینکه تماس مستقیم با منشأ همه چیز.
Which is Allah.
که اونم خداونده، الله هستش که منشأ عشقه.
So, because God, Allah knows what we Before we even say it, he's omnipresent.
خداوند میدونه قبل از اینکه ما چیزی رو بگیم، خداوند میدونه که ما چی میخوایم و همه جا هست.
So if we contact with that even more, so we can even know that he knows. Before he knows that he knows, but we don't know that he knows. And now we know that he knows, and he knows that we know that he knows.
Can I write it down first so I can translate? I will explain to them later a bit more in details, but I'm not so sure.
You forgot? Okay. Yeah. What I mean is before we have this contact, you know, through the Kuan Yin method,
yes.
We are contact directly with Allah, with God.
ما تماس مستقیم با خداوند داریم از طریق همون کوان یین.
Yes. Before we pray to Allah.
قبلاً دعا می‌کردیم برای.
But we don't know that Allah hear or not.
ولی نمی‌دونیم که آیا خداوند اینو می‌شنوه یا نه.
We think that Allah knows.
فکر می‌کردیم که می‌دونه ولی نمی‌دونستیم.
Yeah. Now we know that He knows.
الان می‌دونیم که اون می‌دونه.
We contact. We feel it. We know it.
به خاطر اینکه مستقیم باهاش در تماس هستیم احساسش می‌کنیم و می‌دونیم.
Before He knows that He knows.
قبل از اینکه اون بدونه که بدونه.
But we don't know that He knows.
ولی نمی‌دونیم که اون می‌دونه.
And now He knows that we know that He knows.
بعد اون می‌دونه که ما می‌دونیم که اون می‌دونه.
And we know that He knows that we know that He knows. Clear, no?
اون میدونه که ما میدونیم که اون میدونه که ما میدونیم.
Yeah, that's the difference. Yes.
فرقش در اینه.
So meditation, Kuan Yin method is the best prayers. It's the direct prayers.
پس متد کوانینی که ما انجام میدیم بهترین متد و روش و روش مستقیمی.
Before the Kuan Yin contact, Allah always knows what we want.
قبل از این که کوانین تماس داشته باشیم خداوند همیشه میدونه که ما چی میخوایم.
And Allah always tell us what to do, but we don't understand it.
همیشه خداوند به ما میگه که چیکار بکنیم، منتها ما نمیفهمیدیم.
And now after Kuan Yin contact, we intuitively feel what Allah want us to do and how He helps and how His grace operate every minute of our life.
حالا که کوانینو بلد هستیم میتونیم از طریق تماس مستقیمی که داریم و اون چیزی رو که حس میکنیم و اون چیزی رو که دریافت میکنیم میدونیم خدا چی میخوادش.
We more aware of His will, of God's will.
ما الان بیشتر آگاهی داریم که اراده اون چیه، خواست اون چیه.
The more we practice Kuan Yin method, the more we are aware of God's instruction.
هر چقدر بیشتر ما مراقبه کوانین انجام بدیم بیشتر آگاهی داریم از دستورات الهی.
Because it's at level of the soul.
به خاطر اینکه در سطح روحه.
Which is the greatest of the intelligence.
که بالاترین درجه و مقام هوشمندیه.
It's not like before we practice Kuan Yin method. It's not like God doesn't help or God doesn't hear or God doesn't bless. It's just we're not receptive enough to see or to put it into action.
اینجا نیستش که قبل از اینکه ما کوانینو انجام بدیم اینکه واقعا خدا نمیدونه که ما چی میخوایم. فقط اینکه ما یا اینکه ما چی میخوایم دقیقا، فقط اینکه ما گیرندمون درست نیست، ما نمیتونیم دریافت کنیم که از ما چی میخواد و چه کار باید بکنیم.
Now we're more aware.
حالا بیشتر آگاه.
Every day more.
حالا بیشتر.
Every country has their problem. Yeah.
هر کشوری مشکل خودشو داره.
Every country struggle to be independent, to be strong so that they can protect themselves, protect their people.
هر کشوری سعی خودشو میکنه که قوی باشه، مستقل باشه که بتونه مردم خودشو حمایت بکنه.
And sometimes by doing so it seems like they are isolating themselves or it seems like they are very close in or I don't know. Seemed like a difficult policy, but it is very difficult to survive in this world as a nation, not to talk about as individual, but as a nation. Do you understand?
استاد میفرمایند خیلی سخته که به عنوان یک ملت تو این دنیا. استاد میفرمایند که خیلی سخته که به عنوان یک ملت بتونی تو این دنیا راز بقا داشته باشی و حیاتی داشته باشی برای خودت.
Yes. It is a power struggle between the big country and the small country. Between the the superpower and the less superpower. It is a very difficult political position for every any country to survive.
یه مبارزه خیلی سختیه به خاطر اینکه بتونی نجات پیدا بکنی تو این دنیا و قبلش هم که ایشون فرموده بودن مثل این میمونه که یک مبارزه ای هستش که بخوای قدرت خودتو نگه داری.
So there are some leaders more enlightened than other leaders, but some leaders seem to be more enlightened, but in fact less. Some leaders are less enlightened, but they seem to be like more enlightened.
بعضی از رهبرای کشورها خیلی امکان داره که روشن ضمیر باشن اما بعضیا هستن که به نظر میان روشن ضمیر باشن ولی نیستن و یا اینکه کمتر روشن ضمیر هستن.
So if any government is good or if your government is good in some way, you try to find a positive point and to support that. Yeah, so the government can have some stepping stones to continue and to be better in the future.
باید پوانای مثبت یک دولت رو گرفت که چه کار دارن میکنن، از اون پوانای مثبتشون استفاده کرد که دارن در چه راهی قدم ور میدارن.
Not many government leader or government are saints, but they are all trying their best.
همه رهبرای دنیا اینا مقدس نیستن اما همشون دارن بهترین کاری رو که میتونن انجام میدن، وظیفه خودشون رو انجام میدن.
A government is as good as a country, tradition, religion and political pressure from other country.
یک دولت به خوبی اون سنتی که داره هستش، یعنی اون سنت نمایندگیشو میکنه، نمایندگیشو میکنه.
I know you feel that it's very difficult in your country.
میدونیم که مشکله تو کشور شما.
But I'm sure your government feels even more difficult.
حتی من فهم میکنم دولت شما احساس میکنه که خیلی این تو این موقعیت بودن مشکله.
Consider all the international and political pressure.
وقتی در نظر میگیری تمام فشارهای بین‌المللی رو.
There was a story, you know, like there was an old woman.
یک زن پیری بود.
Who lives under a dictator as a king. He was a king, was a dictator, and she go every day to the church to pray for this king to live long.
یک خانومی بودش، یه زن پیری بودش که توی یک زیر دست یک پادشاه خیلی دیکتاتوری به اصطلاح زندگی میکرد ولی هر روز میرفت به کلیسا برای اینکه دعا بکنه براش.
So people were very surprised. Say, why you pray for this tyrann? He should be dead. Why you pray for him to live long?
مردم خیلی به اصطلاح تعجب زده بودند که چرا میری هر روز برای این پادشاه دعا میکنی؟ این پادشاه باید بمیره، پادشاهی خیلی بدیه.
So she said, before when I was younger there was a king so and so and I felt that he was a tyrann, he was very bad, so every day I want him die and after he died I was very happy.
گفتن من موقعی که جوون بودم، این خانم پیر گفتن موقعی که جوون بودم و یه پادشاهی داشتیم که خیلی خیلی بد بود، من همش دعا میکردم که این بمیره.
And then came another king and then he's worse than the king that died and I pray hard for him to die and then he died and then I was very happy.
بعد یه پادشاه دیگه اومد، اونم بدتر از اون بود.
So and then after he died then there come another king and he's worse than the other two before him.
بعد که پادشاه سومم اومد، اونم بدتر از دوتای قبلی بود.
So I prayed for him to die and then he died and I was happy. It must be a very strong prayer.
برای اونم دعا کردم و اونم افتاد مرد.
But now come this king, he's the worst of all.
بعد اون پادشاه حالا از همه بدتره.
But I pray that he live long because if he die maybe another king come worse than him.
ولی من هر روز براش دعا میکنم که این نمیره چون میدونم اگه بمیره یکی بدتر از این میاد.
I told the Chinese and the Vietnamese yesterday that the Kuan Yin method, the spiritual practitioner of the Kuan Yin method will move mountains, yes, will level the ocean with their power without doing anything. So just be patient, meditate, and world peace will come.
من دیروز به چینی ها گفتم اینو گفتم که کسانی که اینیشیت شدن و کوان یین انجام میدن میتونن کوه حرکت بدن میتونن همه چیزو حرکت بدن به خاطر قدرتی که دارن فقط صبر داشته باشید مراقبه بکنید و اون وقت صلح جهانی میاد سراغمون